Welcome everyone. I hope you guys are having a great time so far with all the great sessions coming. You know, you might have gone through many great sessions and there are many sessions to follow. And my name is Anand Mudaliar and I'm a principal product manager driving the API strategy and the developer experience. And today I'm going to talk about developer portal. All right. So I spend more time in walkthrough. But I still want to get a few points out here. So I'm going to talk a little bit about products and solutions and tools and technologies that we support before going through the walkthrough, and then I'll open it up for questions. All right. So in earlier session, you might have heard many times that we are a global tax compliance company, and we offer many products. We offer products in four major regions. US, European Union, India, and Brazil. And then we offer tax products, which is sales tax, use tax, VAT, custom duty and import tax, lodging tax, excise, communication, and GST. And of course, it comes with the returns and compliance document management and registration and licensing. Now, with all these great products that we have for you, we also wanted to make sure that we provide all the tools and technologies that would help you quickly integrate with our products. What I'm going to walk you through is the list of tools and technologies that we support today. And the number one is SDK. And today, we support SDK. We have six SDKs in six different languages. Which namely C#, JavaScript, Ruby, Python, PHP, and Java. And these are the six languages we support. And the reason we are supporting all these six languages is because we believe that a developer should not have to learn a new language if to implement integration with Avalara. Right. So if you are coming from a C#.NET world, then you should get an C# SDK for integrations. And that's the reason we have built C# SDK, JavaScript SDK, PHP, Python, and Java. So you don't have to learn a new language to integrate with Avalara products. So today we support these are the six major SDKs. Moving on to next, and majority of our products are RESTful APIs. And it comes with extensive API documentation, right? And why? Because we believe that a combination of RESTful APIs with extensive API documentation will help you quickly integrate with your business application. Because all of our APIs are standard RESTful APIs, which are industry standards. And if you are familiar with RESTful APIs, then it's very easy to understand the APIs that we provide for integration. And of course, it comes with extensive documentation as well. And then we also understand security and reliability is one of the primary consideration when you are integrating. So we do provide a secure environment and secure APIs and reliable APIs. So you can trust on that for us, right? And then all of our APIs run on world-class infrastructure, right? Which brings reliability, of course, highly secure, and you can trust on that infrastructure when you are integrating. The next thing is developer trial. So let's say you build your integration with Avalara product. Now, how do you know whether your integration is working or not, right? So we do provide a sandbox environment, which what we call as a developer trial. And you subscribe, it's a free, right? So you can subscribe to developer trial and you can test your integration. You can play around with various features that we have on the free trial, and you can see what you can do, what changes you can do. You can make all the work things, make changes to your integration. And then once you're ready, you can actually move from your trial to actually production. Right? So we do provide that environment for you to simplify your build and integration process with Avalara products. With that, it's time to walk through of our next-gen developer portal. And before I do that, I just want to share a few thoughts here. So we have been listening to developers all along. And that's one of the primary reason we want to make sure that whatever we do in our developer portal is helping you in a way that it can speed up your integration process. It will help you understand how tax compliance works, right? How easy it is to integrate with Avalara products. So we took lot of pride in our developer portal because we listen to our customer, which for us, customers are you, right, developers. And we value your feedback as well. With that said, let me switch gears and start walking you through our next-gen developer portal. All right. So what you see here is our homepage for developer, right? Which is developer.avalara.com. Right now it is CI environment, it's a continuous environment, but you should be able to access developer.avalara.com, and that's our developer portal website. And what you see is a landing page which has resources just to help you with the integration, right? So for example, if you are a developer and if you want to build an integration with us and you have absolutely no clue where to begin, right? So for you, what we provide is a step-by-step guide and what we call as integration guide, right? So for example, if you're building an integration with e-commerce application, we have an integration guide for your e-commerce application. And this guide would be, you know, a step-by-step process that you can follow to build an integration. And if you're not building an integration with e-commerce, let's say you're building with ERP or POS or some other application, we do have a general integration guide that would help you build your integration. And we also provide SDKs, as I talked before. We provide SDKs in six languages, and you can access them. And then we also have API Explorer. And API Explorer is essentially a collection of all APIs in one place. So you don't have to go to five different places to get information about APIs. It's just one place where you get access to all APIs and all the details that you need for API integration. And then if I scroll down a little bit bottom, we do have list of products that we support today. For example, for tax determination, we have AvaTax, classification, cross-border, excise, and comms. And then for we do have other products, like if you're looking for, you know about returns, you want to know about lodging, return for small business, excise, we do have details about these products as well. And of course, the compliance documents, cert capture, and registration are separate. And then at the bottom is a good resource. So if you are new to tax compliance and if you want to get started building your integration, we felt that you would need a lot of knowledge and tutorial that would help you build an integration with Avalara products. So what we do in webinars is we provide a number of webinars in different fields. For example, what I'm sharing right now is how to get started with Avalara APIs. Or if you're building an ERP integration, then how to build a tax integration with your ERP. Or what are the best practices that you should be considering when you are building integration. So we have a lot of resources around in the form of webinars that you can take advantage of. And we also provide universities. How to set up taxes, right? How to approve returns, or if you are using cert capture product, how to manage customers and documents. And we have a lot many webinars and university session that you can take advantage of, and that will help you understand the tax compliance when you are building integration. And then at the bottom, we do provide pre-built integration. So let's say if you're not building any API integration, right, and you want to leverage what we have already built in. So we have 1,000+ pre-built integration, which you can take advantage of. So you can quickly find your integration, whether it's QuickBooks or Stripe or Magento or Microsoft Dynamics. You can just find your integration and start using that. And then, of course, there are resources. We do have a knowledge base, which we call as Help Center. So if you're looking for content around tax laws, if you're looking for content around various products, Help Center is the place where you can go and find those. And then you contact if you if we do provide support. So, you know, if you have questions around different products, you can reach out to us to our support line, and we do have access to support your questions. Now, let's get started. Let's assume that you are building an integration with e-commerce. So you can quickly go through an e-commerce guide. And as you can see, it brings you with this nice interface, and it's a step-by-step guide. So if I scroll down a little bit, just to tell you, is there is a previous and next button at bottom. So essentially, you can actually do step-by-step integration for your e-commerce application with Avalara products, right? And for example, you know, authentication, how to do authentication, or how to do error handling, or you know, how to configure your Avalara tags, and how to calculate your tax offline. So we do have steps involved, and this guide would help you with those steps when you're building e-commerce integration with Avalara products. And we also integrated our APIs within this guide. So which means, for example, in this case, you know, how authentication work, you know, we do provide, let's say, ping the server API, right? So there is a ping API that can tell you whether the service is working or not, right? And if you want to know more, you just click that ping, and you click this orange bar which says view example, and it will tell you right there what that ping API does, right? It gives you sample request and response. It will give you what are the input parameters, and it will give you a definition of each parameters, right? So it's one place for you to build your integration, and it you don't have to go outside this experience to if you want to integrate with our APIs. Quickly going back, let me touch base on the software development kit. I believe this is one of the things that you would definitely need when you are trying to build an integration. So let me, so this, as I mentioned, right, we do provide six SDKs in six different languages. We also have a SOAP SDK for legacy support, but we highly recommend to use our latest RESTful API SDKs for your integration. So you can quickly click one of the things, let me click C Sharp, which is the most popular SDKs for Avalara. And you can just click here, you can see view, you go, it go to your GitHub, and you can simply download that from here, right? So as simple as that. So your same thing for, you have, if you want to do this same thing for Java, you can do that. So essentially you can just click and download and start using it. And then API Explorer, as I mentioned, this is one place where you find all APIs around AvaTax, communication, excise, lodging, classification, sort capture, and everything, right? And what we have done in API Explorer is we identify which top APIs that developers would need to know upfront, right? So we identify those here, right here, as you can see. We have ping, create transaction, resolve address, commit, void, adjust, and audit transaction, and many more here. So we identify those top 10 endpoints that you would need to know, right? So let me click create transaction, which is the most commonly used APIs by our developers. Create transaction, as I hit, right? The center section is essentially giving you a description about that API, what it does, and a brief description about the parameters, you know, all the lines, details, summary. And then it also talks about security policies, what kind of security roles you would need to access this API. And then if you want to know more, let's say, you know, this is not enough, and you really want to know, oh, what give, tell me, you know, what lines means, right? So what you do is you click here, this orange box called create transaction, and it will open up on the right hand side. It will show you the detail of that API. So it will, again, same consistency experience where it talks about the sample request and response. Obviously, right now we only support curl, but going forward, we are going to support multiple languages as well. And then it will give you, you can actually test your API right here. So if you know, you know, you're building your integration, and if you know what you want to include, what's your company code, and you can fill your sample. For example, if I click fill sample data, it actually fills you with the sample data, like date, customer code API, and you hit submit, and it will give you a result right at the bottom here, right? And if I scroll down, you get results right down here, right here, right? And then parameters, which is the most important thing when you're building API is to understand what to pass and what to expect in response, right? So all of our parameters are, a majority of our parameters are model-based. So as you can see, the body itself is create transaction model. And if you want to know what is transaction model, you click that and it will tell you, oh, transaction model means it's, you have to pass code, which is optional, and a string, and a line, which is again optional, and it's an array. But what is line? So if it's a line item model, you click that, and it will tell you what that line item model means, right? So you can essentially go through all the parameters that is needed integrating this API with your application, right? So it's very easy to access this model right here without having to go anywhere, right? So all of these APIs has been built in a way that you get details of API right here as a sample, input, and parameters. Okay, and if you want to know more about models, because it's we are model driven, we also added a section called models, and you click that, and it will give you a list of all models that we support today. And if you click one of those, it will tell you what that model does. Same thing as I shown before, right? Now, let me go back again, and let me quickly touch base. So one of the things that we heard from our developers is ability to search for keywords, right? It is because we have extensive list of APIs, and it can do tremendous amount of, it gives tremendous amount of flexibility for you to build your integration, but it's huge list, right? So it's very hard for you to search, you know, what API you would need. So what we build is search. Here, you can actually search for a specific keyword. Let me search for create transaction, for example. And you can quickly, it will give you an auto-populated list of matching keywords. And you just quickly go to right there to that API. And it will give you the same details about that API. All right, so let me switch gears and show you about that AvaTax demo that we provide. So we also provide a demo where you can actually test and see how our API works. So on the left hand, this is just a visual way of showing how our API works, right? So you have predefined shipping addresses, you know, Seattle, Irvine, Brighton, Toronto, and Brussels, and then as a step one. And then what's being tested? Let's say you are selling, you know, chocolates. I like chocolates, and I also like sushi, right? And you can, and also like, I love baseball, so I'm going to select baseball, right? And I'm going to ship that to shipping address. Let's say I want to ship it to, you know, Brighton, right? And when I submit, you get the request get pre-populated. This is the request that will get sent to system, and it, when you hit submit, it's going to generate a response with tax codes and different tax rates for each of those products. So that's the API tax demo. And then we have, so let me quickly go back to the homepage and show you how you can access support. Because one of the important thing as a developer is you want to have access somebody who can help you with questions, right? So we are we have provided a capability called Ask a Question right here. And if you click that, you can submit your question. My free trial is not working. Please help, right? And you put your email address and you hit submit. And I'm not going to submit that. It's going to send a request to our system. So the moment you submit your request, a team of specialists are watching this queue, and they will be actively monitoring all the requests coming from developers, and they'll be responding in timely manner. So we have a way for you, you know, if you get stuck, there is a way for you to reach out to us, and we'll submit. You know, we'll respond to your question quickly as soon as possible. That's our goal. And with that, I would like to end my demo with a code that this is what we have built for you to simplify your integration. But as always, we love to hear your feedback. We love to, you know, if you have suggestions, you know, absolutely most welcome. We would love to hear your suggestion. And if you think that, you know, there is something that can be done differently that would help you, please reach out to us, and we would love to hear from you. And we'll continuously improve our website to make it more useful for your integration. And thank you. With that, I'm going to open it up for questions.